Hi guys, welcome back to another video. This is Yasser and in today's video, I will show you how to install and set up WordPress locally on your Windows computer using Docker. And we will be using Docker desktop app because it will make our life very easy to maintain and manage containers. Now without any further ado, let's start. The first thing that you will need to have set up on your computer is Docker desktop app. If you haven't already set it up, then there's a video link given in the description below. You can follow that video to set up and install Docker desktop app on your computer in very simple way. Once you set up Docker desktop app, you will have to run that app because without that, this process will not work. Once you will open and start Docker desktop app, you will see an interface like this one. For now, you can see we are not seeing anything here because it is recently installed and there are no volume containers or images there. So you will see a blank thing like this one. The first thing that you will need to do is that you will have to create a folder anywhere on your computer. So for this purpose, go to any folder and create a new folder and name it anything. For this one, I will give it a name WordPress-Docker. And after creating this folder, just open up this folder and in this folder you will have to create a file. Do that, and for this one you will have to give it very specific name, and that is compose compose.yml. So you will have to create this folder, this file here, and then you will have to open this file in any of the file editor that you are using on your computer. For me, it is Sublime Text Editor, so I will use that. I will open up this editor here and then I will just simply open this file in this editor. Now you will have to paste in some code here, like this one. I will give this code in the video description below. You can copy and paste it from here. So just copy it and paste it in this file compose.yml, like this. Now let me define these things a little bit so you have a better understanding of what is going on here. Basically, in this file we will have to define some services, and these services will act as a blueprint for the containers that we are going to set up to run WordPress on our local computer. Here we are defining two services. For one, we have given it a name DB, you can give it any name, and the other one we have named WordPress, and also you can give it any other name, but for simplicity we have given this WordPress, and for the database one we have given this service the name DB. And here what we will do, we will define certain things based on which these services will create containers so we can run WordPress on our local system. For this database service, we have actually defined the image that this service will use to create the container, and you will have to use exactly this name here for the image, MySQL. Actually, what it will do on the background is that it will actually fetch the latest version of MySQL from the Docker Hub, and Docker Hub is like a repository for Docker where it pulls files for a specific image. So here what we are doing, we are defining where to pull this MySQL database. And then we are defining some environmental variables here. These are necessary. You will have to do that. First of all, we are defining the name of the database that we will connect with our WordPress. So I have given it a name WordPress_DB. You can give it any name, but you will have to match it here later. That we will discuss a little bit later. And then we have created a database username and we have given it name db_user, and then we have set a password for this specific user, db_user_pass. We also have to match these things here, and then we have to create a root password for our MySQL. Actually, you won't need it anywhere, but for MySQL we have to set something up, so you can give it any password here. Actually, you won't need this anywhere during the process that we will follow. And then this part is important. Actually, here we have created volumes. This volume here, DB, we are instructing the service to create a virtual folder on our Windows machine that will store the files that will be created by the container. So any file that will be created here in this container path will also be loaded here in this virtual folder on our Windows machine. And why this is important is that whenever we restart or stop a container, it will remove all the files that are saved in this path. So that is why we have saved everything that will be done here by the container into a virtual folder on our machine. So whenever we restart the container, it will fetch all the files and configuration files that is already saved here into the container, and this will help us to actually persist that data even when we restart or stop the container. So this part is very important. And for this part here, after the colon, you will have to write the exact same path, but for this folder that we will create on our computer, a virtual folder, you can give it any name you want. And then for the second service that will be related to WordPress, we are instructing this service to get the image from Docker Hub for this service, for this WordPress. And then this part is also important. So you will have to define a port through which you will be accessing this WordPress container in your browser. So for this left one, you will have to use any port that is free on your computer. You can use anyone. For this one, I am using 8080, and the port number after the colon, you have to keep it 80. Actually, it is the port of the container with which we will be interacting with for WordPress. So it has to be 80. And here again, we are defining some environmental variables. So the first one is the WordPress database host, and normally you will see here some kind of URL or IP, but in this case, because we are in a Docker environment, so we will just give the name of the service with which we want to connect. And in this case, we want to connect this WordPress to the database that will be running on this service with the name DB. So we will just write DB here, so it will automatically connect with this MySQL here. And then for the DB name, we have to use the exact same name that we have defined here. And also for the DB user, we will have to use this name that we have defined here. And then for the DB password, we will have to use this password that we have defined here. So you will have to keep that in mind. And then here again, we have created volume so that our WordPress data is consistently maintained in our this WordPress virtual folder. And for this part after the colon, you will have to keep it as it is in order for WordPress to work properly. And then we have again explicitly defined these volumes here. It will tell the services section and the containers, like actually these are the volumes that we have actually defined within this file. And after you do that, simply save this file. And now again, go back to the folder where you have created this file. Now we have to run a command here. To run command, we have to open command prompt or CMD. And the shortcut way for that is this. Simply go to this file path here and write CMD, and it will open up CMD in this folder. And here you can see that it is the exact same path that is written here. So you have to make sure that you are opening this CMD command prompt within the folder in which this compose.yml file is present, otherwise it will not work. And once you are here, you will have to type in command docker compose up, and then you will have to press enter. And now you can see that it has started to pull the images from the Docker Hub repository. And let's see if we can see anything in our Docker desktop app. Okay, for now it is pulling the data, so we will not see anything here. But while it is pulling the data and installing and creating containers on our machine, I would request you to like this video and subscribe to this YouTube channel for more informational videos. Now I will fast forward this video, and once container setup will be completed, I will come back. Okay, and now our images are downloaded and our containers are set up. So let's verify that. For that, go to Docker desktop app and go to images section. And here you can see that our WordPress and MySQL images have been downloaded. Now let's verify if the containers are running or not. For that, go to this container section here. And you can see this one container here. And if we expand this one, you will see under this main container, we will have two containers with the name WordPress 1 and DB 1, which means that our containers are also running. Now, in order to access our WordPress, you can click on this link here, or simply you can go to your browser and type in localhost And then after that, the port that we have actually defined here to access our WordPress. And after the colon, put in that port number and press enter, and it should show you the WordPress interface. So let's try that. Okay, for now it is showing us some issue with database connection. Let's see if our MySQL server is actually running. For that, click on this container and go to logs and see if you can find something like port 336. It will show that MySQL is running. Now again, let's go to browser and see if it is available or not. Okay, now you can see that we are seeing this WordPress installation screen here, which means that our WordPress is now connected with our database. And the reason why it was showing us that error was that our MySQL server was still setting up. And once it is set up and the connection has been made with WordPress, you will see a screen like this. Here, selecting the language, and after that, click on this continue button here. And then here you will have to fill in some information about your website, like what will be the site title for the website. For this case, let's say Yasir, and username, you can give it any name here. Actually, you will use this username and password to log in into your WordPress dashboard, so you will have to remember that. For now, I am using this weak password, and to use that, I will have to confirm this use of weak password. So I am enabling this option. And here you will have to give it any email here. Actually, you won't be using that much on a local environment, so you can give any email address here. And this option, search engine visibility, will not do much on a local computer because we are not making it live, so it doesn't make any sense to enable or disable this option here. But just for the sake of following best practices, I will enable this option because I don't want this website to be indexed by search engines. And after that, click on this install WordPress button here, and it will install WordPress on your computer. Now WordPress is installing on our computer. It will take a bit, so we will wait for that. Okay, WordPress has been installed on our computer. Now we have to log in into WordPress. For that, click on this login link here, or you can directly go to the login page by writing this URL: localhost colon the port that we have defined here in our file. And then after that, you will have to put /wp-login.php, and you will see an interface like this one. Here you will have to enter the name that we have used while creating and installing WordPress. I have used Yasir, so I will type in that one, and then we will use the same password that we have used during the installation, that was admin123, and click on login button, and it will log you in into your WordPress dashboard. Now you can start exploring WordPress or developing your website or whatever you do with the WordPress. Also, let's have a look at the front end of this WordPress website. For that, again, you can go to this URL, that is localhost, and then the name of the port that we have selected for WordPress, and press enter, and it will show you the front end of the website like this one. Now let me quickly show you how you can stop this container and then again run this container whenever you want to access this website the next time. So go to your Docker desktop app, and to stop the container, you will have to stop this parent container here. Click on the stop button here, and it will stop these both containers that are related to WordPress and MySQL database. Now we can see that our containers are stopped. Now if we go to this URL here and press enter, you will see it will give us an error like this, unable to connect, which means that our containers are not running. Now to run the containers, go to Docker desktop app, go to containers, and then you will have to start this parent container here, and it will automatically start the other containers that are responsible for WordPress and MySQL database server. Actually, it will take some times for these containers to set up. Like we have seen previously, we tried to access WordPress very soon when our MySQL database was still running. In order to make sure these containers are running, go to the logs section of that container by clicking the container name, and it will give you information about this one. Here it is showing this one, which means that our container is good to use. And again, if we go to the container of WordPress, here we are also seeing some logs here, which means that we are good to use this container as well. So now let's go to our browser and see if we can access WordPress or not. Open up the browser and let's refresh this page and see if we can see WordPress front end or not. You can see that we are able to access our front end, which means that our containers are running. So this is how you can stop and restart containers next time you want. And that's it for this video. If you have learned anything new, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel for more content. Thanks for watching.